Good evening. This is All India Radio, the news read by Shabashachi Bhattacharya. Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched Kishan Mandhan Yojana from Ranchi today. The scheme will secure the lives of 5 crore small and marginal farmers by providing a minimum pension of 3,000 rupees per month to those who attain 60 years of age. The scheme has an outlay of 10,774 crore rupees for the next 3 years. All small and marginal farmers who are currently between the ages of 18 to 40 years can apply for the scheme. In Jharkhand, more than 1.16 lakh farmers have registered themselves under the scheme so far. Only small and marginal farmers who own cultivable land up to 2 hectares would be eligible for the scheme. The Prime Minister also unveiled India's second riverine multimodal terminal built at Sahibganj in Jharkhand. He inaugurated it through a digital communication system at a function in Ranchi. Mr. Modi also laid the foundation of Jharkhand Secretariat building. He also inaugurated the newly constructed Jharkhand Assembly building at Dhurwa in the state capital. Mr. Modi also launched 462 Ekalabya model residential schools in the country. 69 such schools will be started in Jharkhand. The Prime Minister also launched Bepar Swarajgar pension scheme for small traders. Commerce Minister Piyush Goyal has said the government is ready to take bold steps on the economy and export front. He said the government is looking forward to exports of trillions of dollars in the next 5 years. Speaking at the Board of Trade meeting in New Delhi today, Mr. Goyal said the government will come out with a program for export credit. He said the ministry is also in the process of finalizing industrial policy. The minister said there are several products which can be expanded internationally. He said 30 million Indians living in different parts of the world want to use Indian products. Defense Minister Rajnath Singh today said that bioterrorism is a real threat and asked Armed Forces Medical Services to be at the forefront to deal with the menace. He was speaking at the inaugural session of the first military medicine conference of Shanghai Cooperation Organization, SCO, countries in New Delhi. The minister said newer and non-conventional methods of warfare are some of the challenges. He pointed out that nuclear, chemicals and bio-warfare further add to this threat. He said medical services of the armed forces are expected to play a role in identifying these challenges. The minister assured the SCO member states that India would continue to contribute positively towards the activities for shared well-being of people residing in the region. Our correspondent reports that this is the first military cooperation event being hosted by India after the country joined the SCO in June 2017. The objectives of the conference are to share the best practices and knowledge to overcome common challenges faced by SCO member states. About 27 international and 40 Indian delegates are attending the conference. Jamiat Ulama-e-Hind has adopted a resolution reiterating that Jammu and Kashmir is an integral part of India and that all Kashmiris are compatriots. At its General Council meeting in New Delhi today, the Jamiat said separatist movements are harmful not only for the country but also for the people of Kashmir. It also said that the inimical forces and neighboring country are hell-bent on destroying Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir Governor Satyapal Malik today rolled out the central government's special market intervention price scheme for apple produce. The scheme will exclusively cover procurement of nearly 12 lakh metric tons of apple produce this season from apple growers of Kashmir division at remunerative prices. Speaking on the occasion, Governor Malik said the central government formulated the scheme within a week, according it top priority, keeping in view the importance of economic interest of apple growers of the valley. He said the scheme is going to be historic for Jammu and Kashmir's farmers. The scheme is expected to enhance the income of the growers in the valley to about 2,000 crore rupees. That's all in this news bulletin. Namaskar.